Hello makers, and I wanted to dedicate this video to a young man that is new in the maker scene, Justin. Although he is quite new at the maker scene, he's very enthusiastic about it. And to be honest, that's all you have to be. So, ever thought of making one of those autonomous robots with an Arduino? Well, you can buy those chassis as a kit from Amazon or eBay. And they come with those motors with an attached gearbox. And I'll tell you about the special thing about these motors as soon as I soldered some wires to it. So I soldered two wires to it, a black and a red one. And I'm put on a wheel so you can better see how this works. And I supply 5 volts to it. That's the cool thing about it. This motor works with 5 volts, so you can power it from a power bank. And now if I supply 5 volts to this motor, it rotates clockwise. Nothing we won't expect. But if I reverse the polarity, it turns counterclockwise at the same speed. See, clockwise, switching it. Counterclockwise. And believe me when I say not every DC motor works this way. But for our purpose it's perfect. You can drive the wheel forward to move your robot forward or backwards, or drive one motor forward and one backward to turn the robot. Well, how should we do it with an Arduino? Well, therefore, there are modules called HBridge. Each of those HBridge can either control 2 DC motors or 1 stepper motor. But we will concentrate on the DC motors today. Well, how does an HBridge work? Well, that's simple. This is a black box. It's the H-bridge. You can think of it that 2 wires go in, one plus, one minus. And the one state is, it will put out plus and minus the way it goes in. But you can also make them reverse the polarity so that here we got plus out and here minus out. And since this looks like an H, I think that's the reason it's called an H bridge. Well, those are 2 very common H bridges. The smaller one is the L9110. This one should handle 0.8 amps per channel. This one you get about 1 euro. But guess what? It doesn't work with these motors. I tried it. Some magic smoke rises. And I burned one of those. It's getting pretty hot. This one costs about 1 euro 50. It's the L298N. It can handle about 2 amps per channel. It's a perfect H-bridge for this motor. See? These are the 2 outputs for the motors. And as you saw, it doesn't matter how you connect it. because it will internally change the polarity, if desired. With these 4 pins you can control the H-bridge, and those are the inputs, the voltage input. This one can handle either 5 volt or 12 volt. So hooking it up, and let's see how it works. Well, let's connect the motors to the H-bridge. And since you change the polarity of the input, there is no right or wrong in connecting the motors to the connectors. So we know that we cannot power these motors to the Arduino, because the pins of the Arduino does put 5 volts out, but is quite limited in the amps it can put out. So we connect a power supply directly to the power input. And let's see, yeah, ground and 5 volts are those pins. Usually those sets come with a battery pack. For batteries in it, we should get around 5 volts. In the middle was ground. And connectors are quite thin. And the board is already powering up. So let's connect an Arduino to it and see how we can make the motor spin. So connecting it is the easiest part. Those are all digital pins, so we need 4 digital pins. Let's say pin 4 to 7. And connecting it to the motor driver. Quite tight. And you notice something is missing. Ground. Yeah, we need ground. And connecting it to the ground line here. Fortunately, no quite good use with this power line. So I guess for this test we use a little thicker wire. Matches a little. You also could use a connector and connect this ground line to the Arduino, because they have then the shared ground. So this line either directly to this controller, or you put this line onto a ground line and a ground line to the controller. Yeah, a little wild. But it works. So just a little coding and we are ready to go. Well, the sketch is pretty simple. The pins are marked on the motor shield from IN1 to IN4. And we're mapping those to the Arduino pins we are connecting it to. We define them as an output pin. And the rest is more a trial and error thing. The first 2 pins control the motor on the left side, and the second 2 pins control the motor on the right side. And it usually works this way. One of those pins have to be pulled high and the other have to be pulled low. And the motor spins in one direction. If you reverse this, You pull the other pin high and the other pin low, it rotates in the other direction. If both pins are pulled high or both pins are pulled low, the motor stops. Here's a little example. We are setting pin to high and the second to low, and the left would turn counterclockwise. Let them work this for 5 seconds. And pulling the pin one to low, so both pins are low again and the motor will stop. And by setting the second pin to high, we reverse the previous state and the motor should turn clockwise. By pulling this pin low again, the motor should stop. And the same thing we would do with the second motor. So let's see if this does the trick. So when we start our Arduino, the motor rotates in counterclockwise direction. It stops shortly and turns the other way. So you can see this one works. Same thing with the other motor. And all over again. Well, last hint. If you program your Arduino control the motors for your robot, think about making separate methods for those motors to execute your command. For example, a method left wheel forward, or left wheel backwards, or left wheel stop. So you don't have to always set those pins manually when you put it in one method. Also, summarize all motor activities in one method. Think about it. And while you think about it, also think about giving this video a thumbs up. Maybe you want to subscribe, because there are more videos like this one to come. Thanks for watching. Be creative. And bye.